Hello guys and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm inside new Opel Mokka and I want to review the new multimedia system from Opel. And let's do it guys. I will show you also the new cockpit, digital cockpit from Opel, and also the multimedia system. If you're new on my channel, just click the subscribe button to see all the new videos, new cars that will come on my channel. And until then, let's start it guys. First of all, I want to start by telling you that Opel come with a new digital display. Finally, they bring it here on the cars, and I like very much the size of it. It's pretty big, 12-inch display. It's full digital display and I love it. I mean, the colors, the brightness, the resolution, it's fantastic. I love the way they do it. The only downside is the fact that you cannot customize it. For example, you don't have any option to customize and to change different views or stuff like that in the front there, like you can do on a Mercedes, for example, or on the Volkswagen. But yeah, it's still great. It still can see a lot of information, for example, the RPM, the speed. You have even the map here in the middle, and also on the right side you have the tank and also the information about the temperature of the engine, and also down here you have the traffic speed limit signs and also the possibility to use the cruise control that you can adjust it from here, from the steering wheel. Other than that, great visibility from the driver point of view. I like it very much. By the way, from here you can change different driving modes. So for example, you can see when you change the driving mode, it will change also in the middle. By the way guys, if you want to see this review with this new Opel Mokka, I already have it on my channel, but in this video it's all about multimedia system. Now, I like very much the way they integrate it here, the same as Volkswagen. It's very nice in this glossy plastic. And we will go to the navigation. It's great that you have some kind of shortcut buttons, physical buttons down here, but also you have the touchscreen possibility, so you can use also the touchscreen if you want to. The screen, it's a little bit matte, I should say. You can't leave fingers on it, but it's also not so smooth. I mean, when you go with your finger here, it's working a little bit slower. So I like very much, even though you leave fingerprint, I will like much more to have a smoother screen like the phones, even though many people complained. You can wipe it very easy. Down here you have audio. You can go in audio. This is the same multimedia system as Peugeot use it those days in their cars. Also, Peugeot will update this multimedia system, probably Opel as well, on the new models. Down here you have the multimedia system. Also, you have the options to the multimedia system, radio station, music file, radio settings, and all that stuff. Audio settings, you have it right here. Balance, sound, you can choose different options, ambient and stuff like that. Then you have the music file, radio settings and stuff like that. All those are here at the audio. Then you can go to navigation. The navigation, as I told you before, is the same one as Peugeot use it. It's a great navigation actually, even though it's work a little bit slower. Once you're setting in the navigation, it's works super nice. Also, you can see it on the cockpit right there and it looks lovely. Very good navigation system. And also when you go out from highway, it's work really nice. It show you the lines, it show you in a nice way. I also have a video about that. If you look at the old 3008 on my channel, the test drive, you will see there I show you and I explain everything about navigation, how it's work also on the highway. Then it's simple search and all other stuff. Here you have the phone. You have the possibility to connect your phone to Bluetooth, so it's very simple system. It's work super fine. You can hear music from Bluetooth. You can also speak on the phone directly from the car. Then you have the set here that get you directly to settings of the multimedia system. And then you have audio settings that you already see it. You have it also here. Turn off the screen. Here you have profile 1, 2, 3. You can save your profile, or you can go to option. When you go to option, you have system settings that you can change: kilometer, miles, Fahrenheit, or Celsius. Then you have factory settings where you can reset to factory, and you have the private mode right here where you can set up some kind of settings here. And then you have the screen configuration where you can configure your screen, the brightness of the screen. And then you have instrument panel. You can choose from here actually what you would like to see right there on the instrument panel on the right side and on the left side. So if you want to see the navigation on the right side, you leave it like this. Driving aid, trip computer, and Yeah, you have a few customizable things, as I told you before. And look at this, you can change it in this way. You can have half of the screen. But yeah, it's not so huge customizable things, but you can kind of customize a little bit, not big deal. But I like very much the screen. I think if they will change it in the future, they will make it much more customizable. Will be a great screen, and it's also nice and big. So those are the main important option and settings. You have it here. Then you have this possibility to connect your Android phone and Apple phone. That's awesome. I will show you also. I will have a special video on my channel. If you want to see it, just check it out. It's very simple, but I will make a separate video about that. Then you have also the options and the settings of the connectivity and networks right here. And then the last one is this car here, where are the most important settings of the car. When you have the headlights function, you can also turn it on, turn it off, adaptive light, mood light, welcome light, guide me home light. Then you have the comfort settings, the doors, unlock, wipers and stuff like that. And then you have the safety features, where you have the emergency brake, speed recommendation, traffic sign recognize, and driver attention warning. So you can turn it on and off from here, very simple. Then you have the driver functions here, where you can have also this blind spot monitoring, traction control on and off, under inflation, vehicle check. So yeah, this is the multimedia system. It's super simple. Nothing fancy, nothing crazy. In the future, I know Peugeot and Stellantis group will update this multimedia system on 308 will be. And I'm really looking forward to see how the new system will work. And guys, I hope it was useful. I hope you make an idea about what you can do with this new multimedia system from Opel. It's a nice one. I can say it's the best one. I can say it's the worst one. It's somewhere in the middle, a little bit upwards. So in the future they will improve it. I like very much, although, the position and the visibility from here. It is just perfect, I tell you. You have a very good visibility, and I like the way they tilt. I like the way they tilt the multimedia directly to the driver. And here you have a big open in the steering wheel, so you can see very well the screen there. So that was all, guys. If you have questions, ask me down below. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the channel. By the way, don't forget to check out the connectivity to Android Auto in this new multimedia system. So, see you there. Bye, guys.